There are a lot of fabulous textures around. They come with all the necessary maps, and some of them are even available for free. I've spoken about those many times before, but the real problem is that they all have their limits. Even though this particular ground texture is perfectly seamless, the repetitive pattern is clearly visible, especially when the camera moves further and further away. Is there anything I can do about it? Sure it is. It's UVW placement randomization tool that was implemented in the latest V-Ray 5 for SketchUp. It's actually pretty easy to use. I'm using a cc0textures.com ground 37 material. In this case, it doesn't really matter what resolution I choose, but mostly you would like to have as much detail as possible. So go for at least 4K. Back to the SketchUp, V-Ray actually. I create the material like I usually do. I add a typical diffuse map. I choose the one that I've just downloaded. And now, here's what you should do next. Go to the Texture Placement tab and change the type from two-dimensional 2D to Mapping Source and choose UVW Placement as a source. It's still two-dimensional, but now there's a little tab called Randomization down here. It has lots of stuff there that helps you randomize your UVS. I'm not going to go through all of them, I'm just going to show you the easiest possible way. So, just tick stochastic tiling and voila, you're done. But what actually happened here? Stochastic tiling make every single texture tile conform to the given parameters. So each of them is shifted on the U and V axis by a value between 0 and 100%. They are also randomly rotated by an angle of 0 to 360, which is actually the full radial rotation range. If we would add scale to this modifier, say 80 to 120, it would also scale each of those tiles accordingly. So that's just crazy randomization possibilities, right? Still, how come the seam is not visible? It's because of the tile blend parameter. If I lower it to 0, the seam is here again. And now you can see each tile being moved, rotated and scaled more clearly. The tile blend makes them blend smoothly together. If we go for a value of 0.3, the blending covers a larger area. Normally, the default 0.05 is enough. If you are still not happy with the result, you can just seed it to randomize the tiles again and again and again until the view is satisfactory. This is what it looked like before, and that's what I came up with. The repetitiveness is not a problem anymore. What about more geometrically defined textures? Like this brick, for example. I do follow the same workflow for that, but I have to disable the UV rotation. Obviously, the brick band is perfectly horizontal, so there should be 0 here and 0 there. It doesn't rotate now, but the problem is V-axis, the vertical one. The bricks move upwards and downwards randomly. It needs to shift by certain steps only, like 18 steps actually, because there are 18 bricks on the map. If I set this step to 18 here, it will only have like 18 moves in V direction. All I have to do now is to find the correct tile blend and seed the randomization if necessary. Great, but what about the additional maps inside this material, like bump, roughness, or displacement. Sadly, they don't follow the same UVW placement by default. But you can copy the UVW placement source map and paste it anywhere you like. So if I want to add bump map, for example, I have to change its texture placement to mapping source, just like before, and paste the copied map here. If I paste it as an instance, it makes all the maps act like components. So if I change anything in the bump slot now, it automatically changes in diffuse, roughness, or displacement as well. Just remember to paste as instance, and that's all. This way, you can make any PBR texture cover an unlimited area. All you have to do is just define the randomization parameters correctly. Go ahead and try it by yourself. Also, consider subscribing to ModelUp channel, where you will find more tips from the SketchUp professionals. See you soon!